I would like to give the word to Mark Vos of Interreg for the last presentation. Mark Vos from Interreg is the coordinator of the Interreg program in the EU Meuse-Rhine region, and he's going to talk to us about the region and what Interreg is doing for the region. Mark, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Pascal, who gives me the floor to say something about Interreg. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Mark Vos. I'm the coordinator of the Interreg project, who is financing this project with 50% BRDF and all the co-financing of the partners who are participating in this project. I want to say something about what's Interreg, what is our program area, and some figures about budget and so on. First of all, to inform you on what is Interreg. Interreg is one of the key instruments of the European Commission to support cooperating across borders through project fundings. So we are financing cross-border initiatives in the region Meuse-Rhine. And the aim is to jointly tackle common challenges and find shared solutions in fields such as health, environment, research, education, transport, sustainable energy, and more. So the big goal is to finance and to support cross-border cooperation. The total budget in Europe is 10 billion euro for the cohesion policy in the actual period, 2014-2020. And with this budget, Europe wants to finance several cooperation programs in the cross-border regions of Europe. The total budget for Europe is 351 billion for cohesion policy. That's a lot. They can use it now for the corona crisis, but of course we have the budget available for our projects. We are one of the cross-border initiatives, and we have a total 10 billion available, and we have 107 cooperation programs in Europe. So we are one of those 107 with a total budget available of 10 billion euro. Interreg Eurasian Meuse-Rhine is investing in 13 regions from Belgium, Germany, and the Netherlands. Together we invest in shared solutions for common challenges, which give us Interreg its own distinct spirit of cooperation across regions and across borders. Interreg exists this year more than 30 years. It's a long history already. Not our program, but the total Interreg in Europe exists now for 30 years. This is our region. It's a top region when you have all those common players in one region. Now we are all splitted by borders, and we hope that we can avoid all those borders and that we can live as one top region without borders. And therefore, Interreg is very important to set up projects without borders. Who are our partners in the project? We have 13 partners. We have the Fédération Wallonie-Bruxelles, the Province de Liège, Ministerie van Economische Zaken en Klimaat in Nederland, the Walloon partner, the Provincie Limburg in the Netherlands, Rhineland-Pfalz in Germany, Flemish Brabant in Belgium, Oost-België in Belgium, the Provincie Limburg in Belgium, Flanders, the Provincie Noord-Brabant in Holland, Regio Aachen and NRW, the Ministry for Wirtschaft in Germany. These are our 13 partners. If you take the whole program area, we have 5.4 million inhabitants. It's a lot. We have a total surface of 18,000 kilometers. And for instance, we have 8 airports in 1 hour, which we can reach very easy. Also, crossing the borders, we have a lot of nature areas. You all know them. But what is important, the total budget or the total business employees in our retail are 400,000. We have a gross product of 180 billion, so that's a lot. When all those areas are working separately, we are very small, but when we can work together, we have a big, big area, and that's why Europe and we try to hide all those borders and work more together. Then we could be a very big economic pool. We have also a lot of knowledge institutes in our region. We have 8 universities, 265,000 students in our area. So there is a lot of activity in the knowledge areas. When we come to the figures of our Interreg program, we are working around 4 accesses. We have innovation, we have economy 2020, we have social inclusion, and we have the territorial development. In total, we have a budget of 96 million ERDF available. We already submitted 78 million in projects. We approved 43 projects at this moment. URM project is one of those 43 approved in the last call, the call 5. And at this moment, we still have 20 million available for new projects. We have launched our new call recently. The call 6 was launched recently. And we are focusing on some subjects, especially in the access 2 and 3. We have still budget available. The ERDF is always limited to 50% of the total project cost. And the other 50% is financed by project partners. For instance, in this project here is the province of Limburg, but also the province of Liège, and 4 other partners, I think, Pascal. So what is available for the call 6 budget? In Access 1 Innovation, a small budget of 2.5 million. It's not so spectacular. But we have in the Access 2 economy, the new economy, 9 million available. We want to address it to a more efficient use of resources in the SMEs. So we have a lack of SMEs in our program. So this project, the QRM project, is very important for us. It's a very good example how we can attract SMEs to our program, and I hope a lot of SMEs will join your project, Pascal. And secondly, we have 4.5 million available in an umbrella project where we want to focus on the more efficient use of resources and SMEs. The same, but then in an umbrella project, and that means that an umbrella project is a project with several smaller projects, and it's more simple to have those budgets available via an umbrella project. So we are looking for partners in those two fields, in the Access 2. And then we still have a budget available in Access 3, social inclusion, but it's not so important for this audience. And also a small budget for territorial development. So especially for SMEs, still 9 million available for cross-border projects. If participants of this webinar are interested, you can contact us or our secretariat to have more info. The deadlines to submit are set on the 16th of June, but we will propose a new deadline to our monitoring committee due to the corona crisis. I think it's not so easy to set up projects in this time frame, so we will have normally a new date by the end of September to give possible project partners more time to introduce applications. So concerning the QRM, a very nice project. It looks very familiar to me because I used to work in one of my previous jobs in an automotive production plant, the Ford production plant at Genk, and lean production and smart production is one of the keywords in an automotive supplier. So it looks very familiar to me, and it's a nice, a very good project. The overall budget is 3.3 million and we finance it with ERDF, means 1.6 million, 50% of the total budget. And we wish all the 9 project partners good luck. We hope you can attract a lot of SMBs in your project to bring more efficiency in the production process and to give them more possibilities to have good business in our region. So good luck to all. I wish you a good project. And for your info, the project manager for this project at the Interreg secretariat is Raluca Daneda, and the regional antenna is also in the webinar is Christina Yors from regional antenna of Liège. So those two people are the contacts in this project. Again, good luck with the project and wish you all the best. Stay healthy in this strange times. Thank you all.
Okay, thank you, Mark, for introducing to us the Interreg program as a whole. So it's almost time to finish this session. We are planning to do a lot more events in the coming period, and everybody who has attended to this session will get more information on the upcoming activities, also about the voucher schemes, the workshops, the boot camps that we will be organizing. You will all be informed about that as well. Maybe to finish off, we plan to send you also a little bit of information through email, through everybody who has participated, and also a short feedback form you will get, where you can also say, please contact me, we are in need of help, or we have some questions. We are here to help the companies in the EM or region to adopt the new technologies. So that's our job, and we are planning to help you as good as we can. Okay, that's it for today. Thank you for attending. Hope to see you the next time.